Hi guys, for today's teardown, something quite unusual. Look what we have here. We have a big metal thing with two air inlets, one written Cyrillic S, one written Cyrillic D. And yes, experts have already guessed what it is. We have here a giant aircraft instrument. One of the biggest one I have ever seen in a diameter. I do not know, it is 13 centimeters wide. So I do not know what is the purpose exactly of this instrument. Is it for prototype aircraft? Is it for giant control panel of flight engineer for a giant bomber? I do not know. One thing you can note, the dial is white background, which is really unusual for aircraft instruments also. It is more in a tuning car, you see this. And it seems we have here a Mach meter, in fact, up to Mach 2.5. So this is interesting and really unusual. So I will open it and we will have a look inside. Okay. All the screws are loose, also the nuts for this air inlet. I will remove the screws because we do not want to lose them. I did make an index in order to reassemble it in the same way it was. And now this front part should be loose, but obviously enough, it is loose. Okay, so as we can see, we have a very sturdy front piece. Really, really, really nice and heavy. It is what I did just drop it because it was heavier than what I did expect. Nice seal around the glass. And here are the insides. I hope it will come. Also, yes, let me see if I'm not doing anything wrong. I must push this piece here. Should come off. Yes. Okay. Because this is attached to a pipe. So, here is what we have. It is overlapping here, so I cannot damage the needle. So, first we have this body, which seems like it is made from one single piece of aluminium, milled in the mass of aluminium, aluminium block. Quite impressive. I just noticed there is, excuse me for the camera shake, there is one more screw here, but it was not necessary to remove it. Maybe it is broken. So this is quite impressive. And in here are the insides. So I guess they are very regular Mach meter mechanism. Maybe nothing special, two capsules, air capsules. Here this inlet has a copper tube going to this copper pipe going to this capsule. Nice structural piece in die-cast aluminium. And lots of small mechanisms here. I will zoom in for you. So Hop, it will be good enough like so, and it will be in focus. So, what do we have? We have three axes. Oh, this one is loose. There is a problem here, obviously. In fact, there is a needle at the back, at the end, and it is rotating in some kind of bearing. But probably this screw here is must be set in order to push on the piece. So we have small counterweights here for weight balance, and we have one gear here driving the needle, like so, which is actuated by the. I guess it is doing some kind of calculation between static and dynamic air pressure, because it is with computing together static and dynamic air pressure, you can know your air speed. So there must be some doing some kind of calculations with this mechanism here. Yes, something like so. There is a little coil spring here, I see, another in here, one here. This part can be adjusted. It is really interesting. Not much, in fact, in this. But all precision set probably in order to show accurate speed. Quite interesting stuff. The dial is just aluminum plate. Really, really unusual piece of kit here. I got it probably from German eBay, and it was probably very, very cheap, if I remember correctly. Because nobody was interested in this thing, but it may make a nice display item, by the way. Here is the, here you have, so this is the serial number, maybe 73 as a dead code. This is the name of the instrument, and the range of the instrument, Mach 2.5 kilometers hours, I guess. Very nice needle with a counterweight at the end, and here you can see the manufacturer logo of the thing. So this is an impressive instrument. So I will put it back together, and it will go back in storage for a few more years. Thanks for watching, bye bye.